Welcome to Guam, USA, where America's day begins. Guam is a tropical island and is the southernmost island in the Mariana Islands. It's also a part of the Micronesia Islands. Guam has an average annual temperature of 85 degrees Fahrenheit and fluctuates from 70 to 90. The island thrives from the popular tourism industry and is considered a hotbed for a variety of recreational water activities. You can find everything here, from paddle boat races to sport fishing, swimming, scuba diving, kayaking, jet skiing, and surfing. With so many water activities occurring year-round, the potential for mishaps is high. The island has lost a number of service members, residents, and tourists who have fallen prey to the waters around Guam. An average of 50 water rescue operations are conducted every year. People who are at risk are those who tend to lack knowledge of water hazards, exceeding their swimming abilities, engaging in risky behavior, and swimming in locations not supervised by lifeguards. This video is not intended to scare anyone from entering the water. In fact, people are highly encouraged to take advantage of the world-class water activities that Guam provides. We just want everyone to enjoy themselves safely and make it back alive. Picture this. It's a beautiful day to go swimming, so you decide to get away from it all and head to the beach. After a while, you decide to cool off in the water by yourself. Within several minutes, you notice the water getting deeper and the current is becoming stronger. You choose to swim back. Making little progress, you start to swim harder. The current continues to pull you further out while you continue to swim against it. Now you're getting tired and panic sets in. You start shouting for help, but no one can hear you. No longer able to support your own body in the water, you begin to sink. Your life passes before your eyes. You start thinking about your family and all the loved ones you're going to leave behind. In less than 30 seconds, you're gone. How did this great day turn into such a tragedy? Do you think this can't happen to you? How different are you from those people who have lost their lives in water fatalities in past years? It can happen to anyone. This water safety video will address the water conditions on Guam, the major causes of drowning, and what you can do to protect yourself from becoming a statistic. One of the biggest misconceptions about Guam's coastal waters is that large waves are not present here. Guam has several large surf locations. The most popular is outside the Agana Boat Basin. The most important safety precaution that you can take is to go with someone who has experience in that area. The most important thing that you should learn is how to evaluate the conditions at that site. Inexperienced swimmers, divers, and surfers are especially at risk and can easily find themselves in serious danger. The large waves tend to slam victims into the reefs, causing injury from reef rash and broken bones to concussions and even death. Several people went kayaking from Piti Bombhole Beach while the surf was still very high, and none of them made it back to shore. Sometimes lives are lost before, during, or after a typhoon when the surf is unusually high and dangerous. Guam is located in Typhoon Alley, which means that typhoons that develop to the southeast around Chuuk, Kosrae, and Ponape usually head northwest towards Guam. Typhoon season is from July to December, but typhoons have been recorded year-round. owing largely to the heavy-duty construction common on island, rarely are there cases of injury or death when people prepare for the worst and ride out the storm in solidly built homes or shelters. The surf has been known to crash over roadways and has even washed cars out to sea. It's very important to stay away from the coastline during the high winds and heavy seas from a typhoon. Currents are also a leading hazard for all beachgoers. They are particularly dangerous for weak swimmers and non-swimmers. The first type is the longshore current. It moves parallel to the shoreline. Typically, an inexperienced swimmer tries to swim against the current in order to return back to where they entered the water. If you ever get caught in a longshore current, swim with the current at an angle towards the shoreline. You may not end up where you entered, but you should be able to walk back to that location once on shore. Longshore currents are strongest at low tide. The other type of current is called a rip current, and is also at its strongest during low tide. A strong rip current can move at a rate of 5 miles per hour, making it almost impossible to swim against. If you become caught in a rip current, the best thing to do is concentrate on staying afloat and ride out the rip current until you are past the kill zone, and then call for help and wait for rescue. Do not try to swim out of the rip current to the side, because you could easily wind up in the kill zone. The kill zone can either slam you on top of the reef or suck you under. This is because part of the wave breaks over the top, and most of the water actually tucks under the edge of the reef, creating a kind of washing machine effect. People caught and pulled under the kill zone have been seriously injured or worse. Sometimes they are held down so long that they drown, and sometimes their bodies get jammed under the edge of the reef or washed out to sea, never to be found. The best thing to do is remain calm, stay afloat, and stay in the rip current. Whatever you do, do not try to swim back in over the reef. Most drownings on Guam are the result of three major causes: the failure to recognize that hazardous conditions exist, the inability of the victim to get out of a dangerous situation. Once a person is exposed to the danger, they are not sure of exactly what to do, or the swimmer lacks the knowledge of life-saving skills to perform a self-rescue, or assistance from others is simply not available. Far too many drownings could have otherwise been prevented had the victims been educated about local dangers and trained in water survival skills. In addition to the major causes of drowning, there are also personal dangers. Panic is one of the largest contributing factors of a drowning. People lose control of their body movements, moving very erratically, and are unable to keep their heads above water. Exhaustion can set in very rapidly when one tries to swim against the current. Severe danger of drowning occurs by the time the swimmer lacks sufficient energy to stay afloat. Cramps are a sudden painful muscle contraction. The most common cramps happen in the calf muscle. Cramps can restrict normal movement and can make it difficult to keep your head above water. If muscle cramps occur while swimming, try changing to a different stroke, or get out of the water if possible and stretch and massage the area. If you are wearing fins, grab the end of the fin, straighten out your leg, and pull hard towards your thigh. This will usually straighten out the muscle and relieve the cramp. Stretching out before the activity and eating bananas or other potassium-rich foods can prevent cramps. Shallow water blackout occurs when a person hyperventilates before going underwater. The condition is often experienced by snorkelers or free divers. The breathing reflex is controlled by the level of carbon dioxide in the bloodstream. Hyperventilation decreases the amount of carbon dioxide and delays the breathing reflex, making it possible for someone to hold their breath until they go unconscious. This usually happens in shallow water, when the person is ascending from their dive. The safest practice is to avoid the kind of overexertion frequently associated with hyperventilation, and to know your limits. If you really want to stay down longer, take scuba diving lessons. It is estimated that nearly half of all drownings involve the use of drugs and/or alcohol. Investigations into drownings have determined that the use of drugs and alcohol slow down one's reaction time and make dangerous situations look less threatening. Victims frequently misjudge weather, water conditions, or swimming ability. Drowning as the cause of death cannot be fully determined in every case, as some victims' bodies are never recovered. There are several types of dangerous sea life that you need to know about. One of the most hazardous creatures is the cone shell. It has super toxic venom that can easily kill a person. The shape of the cone is a gradual taper from the wide end to the sharp end. If you find any shell that meets this description, leave it alone. Sometimes people will put the shell in their pocket or in a catch bag that they carry close to their body. The animal has a very long needle-like spine that can easily penetrate swimming trunks or a bag. Sea urchins have very long, sharp spines that can easily penetrate skin. The spines are also very brittle and can break off in your skin. You may need to seek medical attention to have them removed. A puncture injury from a sea urchin can cause swelling and redness around the area, which may lead to severe pain and infection. Multiple deep puncture wounds may cause fatigue, weakness, muscle aches, shock, paralysis, and respiratory failure. Death may occur. Another animal to watch out for is the crown of thorns sea star. It is covered with 2 to 4 inch spines that can easily break off in your skin. The crown of thorns also has mild venom that can cause swelling. You might occasionally come across a jellyfish. The most common species are very small and completely translucent. They are found just under the surface of the water and can injure swimmers, snorkelers, and scuba divers. The sting from a jellyfish is very painful. First, rinse with seawater, and then apply vinegar or isopropyl alcohol. You can search for more information about hazardous marine life and remedies online. Beach diving is more hazardous than boat diving because rough conditions at the beach can threaten divers during entries and exits. Some examples of popular beach dive spots on island where surf and current need to be carefully evaluated are Gun Beach, Camel Rock, and Ass and Cut. Some spots in Apra Harbor that are accessible from the Navy base are Gab Gab, San Luis Beach, Japanese Fuel Piers, and Clipper Landing. Look out for common underwater hazards like sharp edges on corals, metal debris, and shipwrecks. Also, in areas where fishing is popular, it's possible to get entangled in fishing line. Remember, be sure to evaluate each site carefully before entering. Conditions can sometimes fool you if you don't take your time and really look. Also, always remember that conditions can change very rapidly after you enter. Sometimes the surf picks up or the current changes. It's a good idea to have a backup exit plan in case this happens. For scuba divers who are new to the island, it is critical to go with experienced divers, especially when shore diving. One of the easiest ways to do this is through local dive shops. Most offer free beach dives that are led by certified dive masters and instructors. They are very familiar with the sites and give comprehensive briefs that include the great things to look for as well as the hazards to avoid. You can check water conditions by referring to a tide chart. This should be used when planning your activity. There's more water over the reef at high tide. Plan on entering before high tide and plan your exit at or very soon after high tide. Another way to check conditions is by calling 211. This line provides general information about sea conditions and tides in different areas around the island. Remember, the forecasts are only predictions of anticipated conditions, and actual conditions at the beach may be very different. If small craft advisories are in effect, it's a good bet that the exposed beaches will have dangerous surf. The safest place might be in the harbor. The best way to check conditions is to go to the area that you plan on entering and just have a look. Check the height of the surf, the interval in between the waves and the sets, and the strength of the longshore currents. A popular local way to check conditions on Guam is to toss a coconut into the water and see how fast it moves down the beach. Consider another site if the current is faster than you can swim. If you have any apprehensions that waves are too rough and that the entry is too dangerous, the best thing to do is to go somewhere else, or just do something else altogether. Taking the risk just isn't worth it. Other places to enjoy the water on Guam include the world-class pools and water parks found at most of the resorts around Tumon. While most have lifeguards on duty, their presence should never take the place of close parental supervision. It is highly recommended that everyone keeps in mind the following water safety guidelines before enjoying the beautiful waters of Guam. Never swim alone. If you get into trouble, no one will be there to assist or to get additional help. Always swim where there is a lifeguard on duty. Your chances of drowning are greatly reduced when you swim where lifeguards are present. Always enter the water feet first when water clarity is reduced. There is no telling what is under the water, such as rocks, coral, sandbars, submerged trees, or other objects or debris. Swimmers are exposed to the dangers of head and spinal injury while diving into shallow waters head first. If caught in a rip current, remain calm to conserve energy and think clearly. Don't fight the current. Swim out of the current in a direction following the shoreline. When out of the current, swim towards shore. Observe any posted warnings and remain within the designated areas for swimming, snorkeling, and diving. If the water conditions for your chosen location are not safe, pick another beach. In addition, it's a very safe practice to inform others, such as family members or friends, of your dive plan, where you're planning to go, how long you plan to be in the water, and when you plan to return, so someone can call for help if you are overdue. Be sure to notify them after you get out of the water. Remember that there are potential hazards to almost any activity, and don't ever take safety for granted. With a few simple precautions, you can ensure that your tour on Guam is a most pleasurable and unforgettable experience. Remember, stay safe and have fun.